taco salad. Whoop, whoop. Okay, here's the ingredients. Just a real quick overview. I will have a detailed list of the ingredients in the comments below. We're gonna start off with 2 pounds of ground round. This is my favorite choice of ground meat for a taco salad because I never, ever, ever have any leftover grease that I have to remove. So get you some ground round, 2 pounds. So I'm gonna brown this for a bit. And while that's browning, I'm gonna go ahead and start chopping up my veggies. I'm gonna start with one yellow onion, a medium size is fine. I like to dice it up in pretty tiny pieces. Don't chop those fingers. I'm not a great chopper upper, but you know, I do my best. Okay, here we go. Finished with that. Now I'm going to dice up one jalapeno. I clean out the inside of the jalapeno, make sure there's no seeds in there, rinse it off, and then I like to finely dice it. Obviously, if you're not a fan of jalapenos, you do not have to add this, but my grandchildren eat it and they're 5 and 3 and they don't have a problem with it. So I don't find that it gives it that much kick. Okay, here we are stirring back up that ground meat, making sure to break it all up into tiny pieces. I add 2 packs of McCormick taco seasoning, and I like McCormick's the best. I've tried some others and they just have a different flavor. I'm gonna chop up about 4 cloves of garlic. You can use more or less. You can use pre-chopped garlic. You can use garlic powder, but I feel like fresh chopped garlic just gives it that fresh aroma that I absolutely love in any Mexican dish. Actually, I like garlic in every dish of every Mexican, Asian, American, Cajun, you name it. Give me all the garlic. Okay, next I'm going to chop up my fresh, clean cilantro. I like to roll it up and tuck it in and then chop. It makes it just so much easier. Back in the day, I used to remove the leaves from the stems and you don't need to do that. So I buy 1 pack of pre-made pico for the taco salad just because I am a busy Nana and I don't have time to chop up all that stuff. So I'll just add a little bit of one lime and some fresh chopped cilantro. And here we go with the head of lettuce. I like to clean out the inside, get those bitter pieces out, and I chop my lettuce into bite-sized pieces. I actually had this taco salad with some leftover spinach and it wasn't that bad. I just like the crunchiness of the iceberg lettuce. So here we go, check your fire, make sure bump up the heat to like a medium low heat. I add in 1 stick of unsalted real butter and I get that all nice and melted because I'm about to add the chopped onions. Once those are cleared and sauteed, nice and even, I'm gonna go ahead and add in, let's see what I'm adding in next. It's always a surprise. Oh, some Rotel. Here's the Rotel and now the diced jalapeno. I like to add in diced green chilies. Gives it such a good flavor, y'all. Okay, that simmered for a bit. I got all those veggies softened. Now I'm gonna add in my garlic. And I let that go. I cook the garlic for about 1 or 2 minutes just until I start smelling it. And then I'm gonna add in 1 can of kidney beans that I've already rinsed and cleaned. I'm adding in a couple of tablespoons of that fresh cilantro that I just chopped. And I'm gonna let that cook down for a bit. Now I'm gonna add in 1 small block of Velveeta cheese. We got to have the cheese. Okay, once that's melted nice and evenly, there's my secret ingredient. I add in about 1/3 cup of buttermilk ranch dressing. And it just gives it such a nice creamy texture. It's so delicious. Let that cook down for a bit. And here we go. There's all the ingredients you'll need to fix your salad. I go in with a bag with Dorito cheese chips. You can use taco shells if you want. I add in the meat mixture and the iceberg lettuce, some pico, some diced or chopped tomatoes. I like the little cherry tomatoes and some Mexican 4 cheese. little bit of sour cream. I love all these garnishing ingredients. Of course, some more cilantro, some green onions. Valentina hot sauce is excellent. And then of course the Ortega taco sauce. I hope that you enjoyed this video. This is a great family meal that I think everyone in your family, if they like tacos, it's a nice little twist to tacos. It's a little different, it's a little creamier, but it's definitely going to be something that your family will love. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe.